Hi everyone, I'm Jia Hao from SPD. So I'm a final year student doing information system technology and design, which is something like computer science but just with a fancy name for it, SPD. So I did this last year in June, which is a small little command line tool for you to wrap a single page web app. So why did I do it? If you look at the Mac App Store, right, you notice that a lot of the stuff in the App Store, this is actually the top paid social networking section. And you can see that a lot of these apps, right, are actually simply just wrappers around web pages, web apps and stuff like that. I mean, granted, a lot of these developers, they add in features like notifications, like badges, they try to have different dog icons and stuff like that. But ultimately, it's just a browser and they're charging $4 for it. So I can show you what Nativifier does now. Okay, so in Nativifier you can type and this should work. So what it does is it creates a app for me on my desktop using Electron. So now you can see it here. It's my desktop. So it's here. So if you open it, this is my Facebook Messenger. So it was previously logged in to my account because so it retains the state of the app. So, I mean, it supports notifications. It has dog icons, but the cool thing is that it's cross-platform because it's on Electron. So for example, I can do a --, platform, and say I want Linux. And let's say I want another one, Windows 32. So okay, I'll just show you the Linux one now. So on Linux, so I have my Facebook Messenger I just created here. So, and you notice that the icon, everything is set for you, the title of the app is set for you, this kind of things is actually more complicated than I thought it would be. So in Windows, you can see it. It's linked to my desktop, so it's here. Wait, no. So yes, here I have my Windows Messenger, my Facebook Messenger on Windows. Yeah. So. So you can try it by doing this. So it's a Node.js package. And so the idea behind it is that you just run the command. You don't need to memorize the command line arguments. Like there are actually a lot of configurations, but it's supposed to be it's supposed to set everything for you, and it's supposed to automatically detect everything that you need. So yeah, I did this because WhatsApp web, right? It's after they released it, you have to go open a tab for it on the browser. And you realize that actually these kind of messaging apps, Twitter, this kind of thing, they're actually like something like a native app. So your native apps are like your word processors, your Microsoft Word, Microsoft PowerPoint, your messages app on your computer. So why are these apps actually limited to the browser? Why do you have to open up the browser and then open a tab and then navigate to the page that you want for this kind of applications? So it's actually a bit of a user UX kind of issue where you actually wonder why do I have to see all these back buttons, refresh buttons, the nav bar when all I want is simply just able to interact with my content. Like if I'm using Facebook Messenger, I don't need to use the refresh button at all. I don't need to use the back button. So this is why I actually did it. I actually did it for WhatsApp Web in the first place. So it's hard-coded to WhatsApp Web. I just wanted to play with Electron, and then I somehow realized you could do it. But I'll explain how I did it later. But But yeah, so I did it WhatsApp web, then I realized that it's actually simple to abstract it to be able to be done for any website. So yeah, so these here are the features it has. You can have notifications, you have doc badges, you have HTTP authentication, icons, and flash, which is like sometimes working and not really working sometimes. So I can go into that later. So the so what it's built on is so the app operates on Electron and it's in Node.js, and I tried writing ES6 because I wanted to just like play, you know. So I configured, so everything is configured minimally. So I'll talk about how I do that for I'll talk about it later, sorry. So how it works is you have your command line interface, which is your this, so you can type notifier. And then you can see all the options. I mean, the screen's a bit small now, but there's actually a lot of options. You can see the README on the README also. And so when you enter the command line interface, you can specify options which will be fed into this module, which infers stuff like your title, your icon. It will and then it will convert your icon into a specific format. So if you didn't know, for Windows you need a .ico .ico icon. On Mac you need a .icns, and on Linux you need a PNG icon. So because of the fact that this tool actually works on Windows, Mac, and Linux, you have actually 9 permutations to cover for all these icons, which is quite complex. And so I also have a place for the app, which is where I define all the like defaults and everything. So for example, I set up my callbacks for my notifications on a separate app. So what it does is I feed the options into Electron Packager together with my placeholder app, and then it will churn out for me a nice app for Windows, Mac, and Linux. And so for the command line interface, I use this thing called commander.js, which is actually very cool because you can do so for example, my command, this is my command line file. So with commander.js, I can just type chaos. Can you see? Wait, let me try to get the size. Okay, I'll just copy it to something like this. So you notice that you just need to specify the flex you want. For example, name will be dash dash n, dash dash name, and then I say it's mname. So this is my documentation for mname. And on my help file, it will show me that here I said the flag actually means. So because of this I like this library because you don't have to actually type out this thing manually. You can set it together with your code. And another thing is how you get the icons. So you realize that when you go to a web page, you know that Facebook has this very recognizable Facebook icon, but how do you actually go about retrieving that icon from the how do you retrieve this logo from Facebook? There's the favicon, which is actually a 32x32 image, which is too small. So I tried to find libraries online to do this for me, which is I couldn't find them. So I found this Stack Overflow thread which tells me how to do it, and I made this library called Page Icon, which goes to a web page and then it will find for you you'll find stuff like so there's actually a series of steps you go through. So you search in the favicon location, then you also can search in there's this thing called OG type OG image, which is what Facebook uses to crawl the website for the images. So when you share a website onto Facebook, how does it know what image to use? That's the image that Facebook uses for the website. So there's all these so this library helps me to find the icon I want for the website. But I mean, there's limited success. So and there's also image magic, which is mixed noise. It's an image conversion tool. So it lets me convert the icon from whatever format I want to another format. So I didn't know how to use shell scripting before this, so I had to learn how to write my convert to PNG, ICO, and ICNS file. And the thing is, so this chunk here, right? It's actually quite difficult to convert an icon for Mac. Like, I tried to Google how to get an ICNS file for Mac, and then all the answers online are not working for 10.11, El Capitan. So I did, like, I think I spent quite a lot of time trying to do this through trial and error, and I managed to figure out, like, the options you need to configure the icon. Because you're often more, so you're using this tool called icon utility, which comes from Xcode. And the thing is, a lot of times it just fails silently without telling you why, and then there'll be just no icon, so that's the problem. Yep. So I'll talk about the placeholder M now. So how Electron Packager works, right, is it takes a directory to your app, which... So this folder here is the app folder. Can y'all see? Okay, basically I have this directory where all the stuff here is for the Electron app. So it will go to the folder. So when you tell Electron Packager, you tell Electron Packager I want this folder to be used for my app, and then I'll say, oh, I want this platform, this OS, this architecture, like these icons to use, this page title. So all these things are determined automatically for you, and the idea is this app here, which has been pre-configured with your callback for notifications, is used. So for example, you can look at a preload.js, which is I'll copy it off. So I copy this file to, so this file runs before your content comes on the page. So before I open Facebook on the web page, this file actually runs. So there's this like monkey patch here written by someone on the internet about how you can override notifications. So basically I can set. It's a bit complicated, but the idea is I can set a callback when notifications are triggered, so I can have a talk icon when such things happen. And other things like Flash. So how Electron works for Flash is you need a path to your Chrome Pepper Flash plugin, which is bundled together with Chrome. But the thing is, I don't want to bundle a 20 MB binary in my Node.js package. And I also don't want people to specify, oh, this is my plugin folder. So the process for finding is actually you have to do this, and then you have to find this particular line here, and then this is the plugin directory you want. So I did a thing where it tries to search your computer for this particular folder, which is different for Windows, Linux, and Mac also, and then it will point the Electron binary at this particular folder. So this is how you get Flash to work. But the problem I have now is Electron works on Chrome 47, and now Chrome is on 48. So I think sometimes it doesn't work, but I hope no one uses Flash. Yeah. The other problem is because apps like Netflix, they use this thing called White Vine plugin, which is also here, you see. But the thing is, this one just doesn't work if it's not the correct version. So I cannot just use the same method to get the plugin for Netflix, but Flash should work. Yep. So the challenges I have is cross-platform testing and workarounds to make it behave like a browser. Let me open it up. I have some like apps here. For example. So I can open medium.com with this, and the thing is, you can have your back, forward, reload icon, all these things. You can have developer tools, so you can even use it for whenever you're doing web development, you don't want to open a new tab for your debugging. So you can create an identifier and point it to your localhost 3000, and then do your debugging and stuff. So these things are not bundled with Electron, and it's a bit like for example, you have your clear app data, which because every time you create an app, you run your stuff, it will save a cache of your local storage. So what if you want to create a new instance, and then so you have to be able to clear the app data? These kind of things. These are actually very small things that actually take up most of the time in doing this. The core functionality of pointing the Electron app to a website is not that difficult. I can show you how I do it in a while. Okay, so have you all used Electron before? Do you all know? Okay, what Electron does is it's like a framework for building desktop apps. So, and it's in Node.js and JavaScript. Have you all used Atom before? Yeah. So some with Atom. So Atom is like a, you can think of it as a web browser that runs on a desktop. So you make your apps with HTML and CSS. So you point your app at, let's say you want a different screen of the app, you point it at a HTML file, and then you say, I want this CSS file. So it's exactly like a HTML page. So you add your link element to your CSS, and there you have your desktop app, which is why Atom is actually quite slow, because it's on the browser, but I think they are slowly improving. So I can show you how Electron works now. Yes. Let me try to increase the text size first. Try to use the options.
Control mouse view?
No, I think it's full. Yes, okay. So I'll show you how to create Electron app. It's actually very easy and it's pretty fun to use also. So first you need to do a npm. Okay, I'll show you. Yeah. So you do an npm init. And you go through the options. Are you familiar with npm? Okay, so what npm is npm is a package manager. So when you create a project, you specify this npm, this package.json file, which is a file where you say you want these dependencies, these items. So it tells people what your project is about. So for example, I will need to install Electron preview, this tool to make Electron app. So it's called, so when I want to install I do npm install /save electron. So the save flag actually tell the package.json to save the dependency inside. So next time when I don't have to commit my dependency into Git, I can send it to my friend, and then when my friend wants to set it up, he types npm install, and all the listed dependencies will be installed for him. So this should not take very long Okay, never mind. So I'll go into the how to make app first. Okay, first you create a main.js file. And you tell it I want var electron equals require. So this is how you Are you familiar with Node.js? Okay. Require is how you import modules for Node.js. And you can, I want my browser window, so I browser window equals electron.browser. So I have a function which creates a browser window. I actually saved the steps in Git itself, so I'll just explain them step by step through Git. So Git check. So in my package.json, I tell it my main.js file is my main.js, which is this line here. Main.js, and I have a start script, which is electron main.js, and this just now I installed this dependency, which is electron preview. Okay. So this I only changed three lines from the original file, which is this, this, and this. So now this is my main.js file. So now check out step two. Yes, so this is step two. So require electron is importing electron, then you get the browser window object, and then you create a new browser window and you point it at index.html, which is a file within your local directory. So and so this file is in here. So I have my index.html here. So I've created a empty HTML document, which is just my awesome app. And hello. And after that, you can step four. So you import the app module, which is I think the main process for Electron, and then you tell it app on ready, create a main window, and assign it to my main window variable. And now I can start it. So I run npm start. So when I run npm start, it runs this script here. This script here, which I've defined here, electron main.js, and see, here's my app. So, what's step five? Oh, so I added some CSS here, which is I added the style sheet here to main.css here, and I'll do the same thing. Electron is awesome. Because I just changed the header and added some basic styling. Okay, so how does Netlify works is it changes this URL for you here. So previously it was this, and now I change it to facebook.com. So meaning that I don't need to bother about this, the index.html and the main.css again. And now when I run npm start, it will create and point it to Facebook. So this is how Netlify works, which is just like quite simple actually. But yep. But the thing is, even you notice that they have all these window options now, right? But when you package it, these items will be gone because they are not part of the Electron package. So I'll show you how to package it in the app. What you need is this thing called this thing called Electron Packager. So I've talked about it just now. You install it by npm install Electron Packager. But I won't run it here because it'll take very long. So with it, right, I can create an app because I'll do this. So this is the syntax for the Electron packager. So I'll say I want to put it into this directory, awesome app. Wait, no, awesome is the app name, sorry. Awesome app, then the platform is Darwin, Mac, 64-bit, and then to the desktop, and overwrite. So I'll throw this into my terminal, and then it will create an app that should work, which is here, which is exactly what your code here does, facebook.com, and here's the app. So but there's it's very basic, so you don't have all these menu icons and all the kind of things. Yep. So this is essentially how I do Netlify, and then I added like how I made it read a JSON file for configuration, this kind of thing, so it knows what to do when it, so this is the place for the app, but it knows what to do when I configure it differently. Yep. So, but the bad part is, these apps are very big, and because the browser is slow. For example, this app is 115 MB, so it's big. Yep. So because it bundles the entire Chromium together with the app itself, I think there might be some way to actually make it share a single app and then just configure it differently, but I'm not exactly sure how to do it and probably don't have time for it later. So yep, so I'm done. And if you're like, you can contribute on GitHub. Any questions?
So earlier on when I got to my Mac, I found a bit about this app called Fluid.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know about it when you made this app?
No, I didn't. But I knew about it after I made it.
Oh, okay.
So
yeah. So do you know about the main differences? Like?
Yeah, so Fluid is on Safari and it's an older version of Safari, and Safari itself is old compared to the current HTML spec. And so certain features might be deprecated, and also you have to pay for it. I think you have to pay for it. It's closed source. You have to pay for certain features of it. But this is open source.
How do you handle like native notifications and that?
Native notifications.
Yeah,
oh.
Do you have notifications?
Yeah. I don't handle them. They are handled by Electron.
Not all the apps how do you handle badges?
Oh, badges. For example, Facebook will have this like bracket and the number there, so you can read the title and then you can set it to the badge like, from there.
So for all the apps, you just like match this bracket number.
Yeah. But I didn't set it for by default, so that has to be turned on through a flag. But their notifications are handled by Electron because Electron has their own API. When they receive notifications, they will automatically trigger the local native notification. But to get the dog icon to appear when notifications are triggered, that one requires like a sort of a hack of the notification. So you override the notifications API and then you say your callback, specify your callback there.
You mentioned cross-platform testing was a challenge. Could you explain more about how you solved that problem?
So I tested most of the code on my Mac, but sometimes like certain things don't work on Linux. For example, I didn't know that when you have a space in your file name on Linux, then when you try to it runs normally, but when you put it to your doc here, right, it will like just not work for some reason. So it's a lot of because I have this friend who uses Linux also. He's not here, so but he contributed a bit and then he will tell me that, oh, this is not working. Then he will get me to fix it. Yeah, so I try sometimes. But like you said, it's hard to actually debug on other platforms. So for example, quite a lot of changes, I want to test on another OS, I have to use this VM here and I have to like git pull and then like npm install again, which takes forever, and then I can try. Then let's say I want to change the code, then if I change it in Linux, I have to go back to my Mac to actually finalize the changes. But I think you can set up like some siblings or something, but your dependencies are different because your Node.js packages are compiled differently for each OS. Yeah, so that might not be good. So yeah, so usually people will open issues and then they will say, oh, this is not working on Windows, then I can look into it sometimes.
Since your project is quite popular, how do you popularize it?
I posted it on Hacker News. So I actually posted it last year in June, but there was nothing, because And I realized that at the end of the year last year, I realized that because how it worked last year was it you have to configure it just like Electron Packager. So I showed you the syntax just now, which is this whole long string of things. And all I did last year was I added a, so you put your facebook.com there. Something like this. So this is what I did last year, and it's actually very difficult because you use Linux, you want to avoid, personally for me, I try to avoid using command line flags. I don't know what they mean, and I don't want to read the documentation. So I made, like, for example, platform, I made it like detect your current platform, I made your architecture detect your current architecture, so everything just have some defaults. And so I posted it on Hacker News again this year, and somehow, like, somebody emailed me and then saying that your thing has been picked for your front page, so you'll be on front page for a few hours. Then from there, like, people like upvoted it, and then it stayed on front page. Then it got to GitHub trending, and then it stayed on GitHub trending. Yeah.
So right now to use the app, you kind of need to know how to use the Domino NPM and everything else.
Not really, because. Okay, maybe, yeah, you need a bit lah.
Yeah, because
yeah.
Like, if you are not like a terminal user, you don't even know what NPM. So
yeah.
Is there a plan to make a GUI app?
I actually tried to do a GUI for it, but it just didn't work. Like, I don't really know why, but so there's some conflict with the file system or something. I made an Electron app to do this for me. So I can actually show you. But,
bootstrap
it. Yeah. So I did it here. So basically it's just an Electron app with a form. So it tries to create an app for me. Like, it works when I don't run it in Electron, but when I run my API in, because you can run the Nativeyer thing as a Node.js module here, so by configuring it like this. So I mean, these are optional, you can just specify the ones you need. But when I tried to do it in the Electron app itself, things just didn't work. I didn't know why. I didn't have time to fix it. So I left it like that. Yeah. But I think it's actually a good idea to have that GUI for people to just, I mean, so people who don't know how to use command line tools, people to use it.
You can create an issue on GitHub.
Yeah. So right now I'm looking into like trying to make it like, instead of packaging the app itself, I make it package installer instead, so you can pass to your friends and stuff like that. And then other like details. So for example, your icons, you realize that it's not possible to always get a high resolution icon. So I did this like hack on GitHub. Like, I posted my stuff, my icons on GitHub, then I used the Jekyll pages to have a link to my icons, so I can show you here. It's actually quite interesting. So I created this GitHub pages where I have my Facebook image here, and then I have my Gmail image here. So I will try to find search this website first for the file before I try to automatically retrieve the icon. So how it works, this thing is actually pretty cool because I'll just show you. So you just have to put your items in your files directory, your icons in here. Then you put them, then you have a data file which says that, oh, these are my files. And then GitHub will generate for me the web page on its own through Jekyll. So I didn't, you cannot, because I wanted like an index of the file, so I can straight away know that, oh, these are the files, these are the link I want. So I have, when I straight away request for the page, I just need to pass the HTML, which is actually very easy because you see here, it's just one, and all the anchor elements go here with the name and the URL. So it's actually really easy to pass, and I wrote a parser for it as well. Any other questions?
No, let's give you a round of applause.